Hello everyone, my name is Bastien Malin, and I'm going to talk to you about the continuous time version of the Derrida Auto model. This talk is based on a joint work with Yun Hu from Sorbonne Paris Nord, and Michel Pin, who currently works at NYU. The Derrida Auto model can be thought of as a dynamics on the set of priority distribution on the positive half line. It can be constructed as a process in the following fashion. We start at time 0 with a non-negative random variable x node, and to construct the random variable x1, we take an independent copy of x node, sum our two random variables, remove one, and take the positive part. And similarly, for all positive n, to construct xn plus 1, I just take two independent copies of xn, add them together, remove one, and take the positive part. So we obtain this way a process that we refer to as the Derrida Auto model. This process was previously introduced by Cole, Ekerman, Glaser and Martin for x nodes that was integer valued, and they were studying this process as a process on a tree. Indeed, to construct the process xn, it is very natural to make a binary tree appear. See that for constructing x1 from x node, what we need to do is sample an independent copy of x node that way, and add the two values together, so 2 plus 2 equals 4, minus 1, 3, and I take the positive part, it remains equal to 3. So now, to construct x2, I need to construct an independent copy of x1. And to do so, well, we just need two new independent copies of x node. So to construct x2, we start making the following binary tree. So note that the two new values with same law as x node were both equal to 0, so their sum was equal to 0, minus 1 gives me minus 1, and the positive part gives me 0. So putting things together, we get that x2 is equal to 3 plus 0 minus 1 equal to 2. And we can continue growing the process this way. And what we see is that to construct the random variable xn, we need to make a binary tree of height n. The Derrida Auto model can be thought of as a parking process on the binary tree. If we replace internal nodes of the binary tree by parking spots and the edges by rows, we obtain the following picture. And then, the variables x nodes that we put on the leaves, this can be thought of as cars that try to park down the tree. So all cars, they always drive downwards towards the root of the tree, and they park at the earliest available parking spot. So what happens is that at first generation, the cars, they climb down one generation, and if a parking spot is available, a car will park there. Otherwise, they just keep climbing down and down and down until a remaining amount of cars leave the tree. So in that case, we have x4 that is equal to 2. A natural question to ask here is about the number of cars that will eventually leave the tree. Depending on the law of x node, we expect that this number of cars should either be relatively small or grow exponentially fast with the number of heights in the tree. So we can observe that the quantity f infinity, which is the limit as the n goes to infinity of the expectation of xn, the average number of cars leaving the tree, divided by 2 to the n, this quantity always exists. Cole, Ekerman, Glaser and Martin showed that if x node is integer valued, then there is a necessary and sufficient condition for the expectation of xn to grow at a sub-exponential speed. And they showed that, well, if this integrality condition is satisfied, then f infinity is equal to 0, and in fact, xn goes to 0 in priority as n goes to infinity. This means that with high priority, every car in the park will park with priority that goes to 1 as n goes to infinity. On the contrary, if f infinity is positive, then the number of cars that remain in park grows like f infinity times 2 to the n. This allows us to define supercritical, subcritical, and critical Derrida Auto models, depending on whether the variable xn goes to 0 or grows exponentially fast. So we see that if x node is integer valued, Then the Derrida auto model is supercritical if the expectation of x node 2 to the x node is larger than the expectation of 2 to the x node. It is subcritical if the inequality is in the other way, and it will be critical when the two quantities are equal. Note that the question of determining an integral test similar to this one, if the random variable x node is not integer valued, is still an open problem. Even in simple case, for example, if x node is half integer valued, which would correspond to the parking process, where at each internal node, instead of one parking spot, you get two parking spots. So some conjectures exist on the Derrida auto model on the boundary case, so when it is critical. Under some integrability assumption, the expectation of x node to the cube times 2 to the x node is finite, we believe that the priority that xn is positive, so the priority that some car leaves the parking space, decays as 4 over n squared as n goes to infinity. And moreover, we believe that conditionally on having at least one car leaving the parking space, the number of cars that leave is distributed as an exponential, as a geometric random variable with parameter a half. And moreover, conditionally on leaving the tree, we believe that the connected component of full parking spaces that contains a root creates a tree that has an order of n squared list, so a very small subtree of the binary tree of height n. So now let us introduce a continuous time version of the model to study the previous conjecture. So take a Yule tree of height t instead of the binary tree. What we do is that we start with id amount of panes on each leaf of the tree that are all sampled according to the same distribution. So we paint down then the branches of the tree using a quantity of paint of 1 per unit of branch length until no paint remain in the box, right? And at every time two painters merge, they put the remaining amount of paint in common. And the quantity of interest here is the variable xt, which is the quantity of paint that remains at the root of the t. And this process xt is what we call the continuous time Derrida auto model. So we can compute the density rho t of the Derrida auto model at time t, and we can observe that it is the weak solution to an interesting partial differential equation, which is derivative in time of rho, is equal to the derivative in space of rho indicator function that x is positive. So this represents the fact that when the variable is strictly positive, you pay one amount of mass per unit of time, but when the quantity is equal to zero, you pay nothing to climb down, plus convolution of rho with itself minus rho. So these bits come from the branching times of the Yule tree. So what can be observed about the previous PDE is that it has an interesting exactly solvable version. So if we look for solution of the previous PDE of the form combination of a direct mass at zero and an exponential random variable, we observe that the PDE reduces to the following system of ODEs, which means that in the Derrida auto model, at least in continuous time, mixtures of exponential random variables are stable by the transformation induced. And well, to solve the above ODE, what we can observe is that the quantity H, which is P over lambda plus log lambda, remains constant under the dynamics of the system of differential equation. So this gives us an integral of the motion. And once we have this integral of the motion, we can construct the phase diagram of the system. So I draw here some lines that are of the form P over lambda plus log lambda equal to a constant. So observing that lambda has to decrease when it follows this ODE, we can observe that Pt lambda t follows the black lines according to the arrows. So we can describe three phases of this phase diagram. The subcritical area in which Pt lambda t will be absorbed by the line p equal 1 lambda larger than 1. And this corresponds to the case where f infinity is equal to 0 and xt goes to 0 as t goes to infinity. Similarly, we have the supercritical area where the pt lambda t will converge as t goes to infinity toward 0, 0, which means that with high priority, the random variable xt will be positive and distributed according to an exponential random variable with very small parameter, or in other words, with very large meters. So this is the exponential growth area here. And so we have the critical lane over here, where pt lambda t goes to 1, 1 as t goes to infinity. And because we have a simple differential system, we can also know pretty exactly how does pt lambda t behave as t goes to infinity. So as t goes to infinity, we have that lambda t behaves as 1 plus 2 over t plus a little o of 1 over t, and pt like 1 minus 2 over t squared plus a little o of 1 over t squared. So note that, in particular, the priority that xt is positive behaves as 2 over t squared instead of 4 over t squared. And the reason is that we believe that our exactly solvable model does not satisfy the equivalent of the x cubed 2 to the x integrability condition that is needed in the discrete model to satisfy the conjecture. So this is my time. Thank you very much for your attention.